So the Sanders campaign certainly the loudest tonight, but we do not know what the second alignment was. So it's important to know as we prepare for this evening, applause and enthusiasm certainly is important, but the votes are the most important.
This is the Bernie group. It's so big that, in fact, that middle section right there with all those folks in it, that was the Joe Biden section. And they actually moved the Joe Biden section because they didn't have room for all the Bernie supporters that are showing up here. So this was all supposed to be Biden here. It has all been washed away by Sanders support. And you can see they're out of room again.
But it is interesting that in downtown Des Moines, right now, at this one precinct, Yang is representing better than an eight-year vice president.
The Joe Biden group, probably not going to be viable. Those folks will then go into the middle.
The Joe Biden section, not too much. It's the question whether they will be viable or not.
No, I don't think that there's such a thing as an undecided person. My next door neighbor is pretending to be undecided so that people will woo him.
Okay.
That's a quote.
And we will see where all of this goes right now.
And the whole front and the back side.
They're actually saying that they have some spoiled ballots here. So we're going to sort that out now here as well. And we will try to figure that out.
One more look at, oh, they're gone. The Joe Biden folks are gone. There's two left. There was like five and they were hanging tough and now they're gone.
So we're splitting delegates with the Warren group. And then we also sent some folks to Yang Gang members to Biden. And we're going to get one of their delegates as well.
So you had zero. And now how many do you have?
We have two.
And you have?
One, probably. Whatever, we just made a horse deal in good old-fashioned Iowa, and everybody's happy.
This is what democracy looks like, probably.
Yeah, I was just texting with a party official in Iowa who says that the party is doing quality control on some of the results coming in right now, and that they should be reporting out some vote near the top of the hour, about 15 minutes from now. But at this moment, what they're doing, according to this party official, is quality control of the reporting results they are getting from these precincts at the moment.
What does that mean, quality control?
State party is doing some quality control checks to make sure they are confident that the numbers they're getting and reporting out publicly are accurate.
It is about 12:30 on the East Coast, and we have no results.
Zero, there's some from the AP, but we don't
even really have partial results. There were hiccups in the reporting process of reporting those
hiccups
results.
Hiccups is quite the euphemism.
Let's be clear.
Yeah, go ahead. This
was not the plan. Something is clearly off from the plan that the Iowa Democratic Party had at the start of the night.
Okay, so let's start with the basics. We don't have the results. What happened? Claire, what went wrong? Why don't we know the results of the Iowa caucuses?
It's a complicated question, actually.
Yeah, try to answer that succinctly.
We don't have the results because, reportedly, although still kind of fuzzy,
out of an abundance of caution, we asked, when do you think you will begin releasing results? They said there is no ETA at this point.
What's going on here? Quality control.
It's a total shit show.
You know, a couple hours ago or so, maybe we got a report from Jeff Zeleny, among others, saying Iowa's Democratic Party organization is troubleshooting what they described as multiple reports of technical trouble with a mobile app designed to transmit vote totals from precincts to state headquarters. And it quotes a party spokesperson, Mandy McClure, Iowa Democratic Party communications director, saying from the beginning that they've been prepared to deal with issues of human error and poor cell service as they arrive.
There are reports that campaigns are similarly ill-informed.
All right, Mike Memoli at Biden headquarters, where they officially know nothing.
And honestly, we haven't really heard a clear or particularly informative statement from the Iowa Democratic Party.
It doesn't look like we're going to get Iowa results anytime soon.
Right. Let's go to Jeff Zeleny and see. He's in Des Moines. What are you hearing over there, Jeff?
You're good to go. Party officials have been hunkering down, I'm told, in a war room.
To maybe knowing you're going to have a bad night or maybe not. I don't think anyone really knows
Biden,
much.
You mean Biden's team.
Biden's team, yeah. Right? Like, it's a little Trumpian to kind of throw doubt on the process. With that said, like, the first rule of crisis management is tell people what's happening, right? And we don't have any idea what's happening, and I don't think anybody has any idea what's happening.
I mean,
right?
for like just a little example, we were watching CNN in our newsroom, and Wolf Blitzer was interviewing a precinct secretary who had been on hold for an hour apparently with the Iowa Democratic Party tech line.
Well, Wolf,
I have been on hold for over an hour with the Iowa Democratic Party. They tried to, I think, promote an app to report the results. The app, by all accounts, just, like, doesn't work. So we've been recommended to call into the hotline, and the hotline has not been responsive.
Have you gotten any explanation at all as to what's going on?
No, I have not. No. I'm just waiting on hold and doing my best to report the results from my precinct.
What are you hearing? I know you're listening to a conversation from the Iowa Democratic Party.
This is a real coincidence, Wolf. I just got off hold just now. Uh-huh. So I've got to get off the phone to report the results.
All right. Go ahead and report your results. Can we listen in as you report them, Sean?
Yep.
All right, cool. Let's listen.
All right. Okay. Hi. Hello? They hung up on me. Okay. I've got to get back in line on hold.
But as our team has been noting all week, there have been concerns raised about this new app for the phones the precincts were going to call into the party using this app, and whether questions about whether or not it worked properly. We've been reaching out to all the campaigns to try to find out if they know anything. They don't seem to know much more than we do.
Biden's campaign sent a pointed note from the campaign lawyer to the Iowa Democratic Party saying we deserve answers. And then perhaps a little recklessly, I might say, I just saw a report on Twitter from a Biden surrogate, Chris Dodd, basically saying maybe we shouldn't trust these results at all.
It's a little, well, we were saying, and I'm going to use this term because I'll take the heat for it. It's a little Trumpian.
I think tonight was a great night for Mike Bloomberg. Yeah. It was a great night for somebody who can argue competency at being able to run a big organization.
The most we can say is that there were reportedly technical problems with the app that, as you say, Galen, precincts were supposed to report the results. There were also lots of reports of problems with, like, the backup processes if the app failed, right?
Yeah.
Which means you can still call in the results if you're not using the app, which is how they used to do it in Iowa.
Exactly. And to Claire's story, there were apparently people waiting forever to do that. There were problems with that. And there were also
reporting about the app at the center of this, which appears to have been developed by a company called Shadow that is associated with another firm called Acronym. David Plouffe, I know you've worked with Acronym. I've seen some reporting in Huffington Post, and Lee Fong and others have sort of walked through the connections. I just want to ask you if you've had anything to do with this app, if you know about it, if you have any insight into this.
I didn't know about it, so I'm helping Acronym. I'm a volunteer on their board. And
what is Acronym?
So Acronym is a digital firm that works on digital advertising. Puts out a newsletter every week about what's happening in the presidential race. My understanding, as I just texted the CEO, is Acronym's an investor in Shadow. I guess Shadow's got its own board of directors. So in my relationship with Acronym, which has been going on for a few months, I have no knowledge of Shadow.
So you weren't sitting up there the whole time being like, I actually developed
no.
this app. Okay.
I didn't know if it was Microsoft or who it was. Not to throw them under the bus, it was news to me, but anyway.
Mayor Pete is sort of declaring.
We have a tweet here at 12:24 a.m. from Pete Buttigieg's account that says, Iowa, you have shocked the nation. By all indications, we are going on to New Hampshire victorious. We have no indication.
So we don't know all the results. But we know by the time it's all said and done, Iowa, you have shocked the nation.
Of the 1,700 precincts reporting now, we have 25% Bernie Sanders.
You have 32 of the, it's 1.8%.
1.8% okay. Of the vote that I'm giving you here.
And when every achievement in one person's life feels like a photo op, just so that you can move on to the next one, and then when you start asking questions and he gets very enraged, like when the New York Times pressed him on the Canadian bread price fixing scandal, right? You see that rage in his eyes.
On the-
the front lines of corporate downsizing. You've been on the front lines of corporate price fixing. You've been on the front lines of our misadventures in foreign policy. You've had direct experience of many of the things that make a lot of young people very angry about the way that this country is operating right now. You don't seem to embody that anger.
So the proposition that I've been on front lines of corporate price fixing is bullshit, just to get that out of the way.
You worked for a company that was fixing bread prices.
No. I worked for a consulting company that had a client that may have been involved in fixing, or was apparently in a scandal.
I don't know. I mean, slow is one thing. Zero is another.
And no explanations either.
It doesn't make a lot of sense. And like, you know, the point of having a backup system is like having a relatively fully functional backup system, right?
The Democratic Party in Iowa did issue a statement, so I just want to get that on the record for the podcast. So can I just read that?
Yes.
And this is from the Iowa Democratic Party.
Communications Director Mandy McClure. Wolf, I'm just going to read this from my computer screen. Please. Here. Found inconsistencies in the reporting of three sets of results. In addition to the text systems being used to tabulate results, we are also using photos of results and a paper trail to validate that all results match and ensure that we have confidence and accuracy in the numbers we report. This is simply a reporting issue. The app did not go down, and this is not a hack or an intrusion. The underlying data and paper trail is sound and will simply take time to further report the results.
Now,
after that came out, though, we still heard reporting that there was something wrong with the app.
Well, there's sort of inconsistencies within the statement, actually.
And you know what? You have to give them credit for that. I mean, in the sense, if this is in fact what is happening and that they have these safeguards in place, then we're all just going to have to wait a little bit to get those results.
You don't have ballots, though, because there's no ballots. It's people and not ballots. But, like, there are witnesses and people are very concerned about this and, like, but it's really strange. I can't remember. We've been through, as a podcast, you know, a lot of weird nights in American electoral history. And, like, this is really weird.
Yeah, it is.
Irrespective of this, like, whole app nonsense, there's still, you know, caucuses that are flipping coins to decide crap tonight.
Yes, literally.
I mean,
yeah,
like, you know, the system doesn't have to be broken as phenomenally as it kind of currently is for it to still be dumb, right? And I think that all of that is on
display.
That's
such a great point, though, about the Democratic Party and this fusion of wonkery with incompetence. Mm-hmm. The fact that they keep having this, like, obsession with quote-unquote smartness and then not delivering the goods on it. That was the Clinton campaign.
True. Yeah,
it was like, you know, all these stories and all these right-wing conspiracy theories about how evil and awful they are. Well, if only it were so. Yeah. They don't even have the efficacy to not be at Martha's Vineyard while they're campaigning against Donald Trump.
Yeah.
This is another example. Oh, let's have an app. Let's do that. Maybe Uber can deliver the app results somehow through some type of cloud service.
Well, Michael, I see that Chris Matthews said Bernie was going to do well tonight because a caucus is like a meeting and socialists love meetings.
True. I have to say, as a socialist, I hate meetings. Yeah. But I will give Chris credit. I think he, you know, he had a beer with a doctor.
With a doctor.
All right,
New Hampshire just became super important, and there are 2 weeks between New Hampshire and Nevada. Did Nevada just become really important too? Like, more so than it would have been.
Nevada, another state that has a reputation for
caucuses. Okay.